going to start our fifth chapter, lines and angles. In this chapter, we have to study about different types of figures and different types of the concept based on it. So, first we will start about line. A line has neither starting point. You all know about the line. Line is simple, we draw with the help of pencil. But a line has neither starting point nor ending point, means we can extend it in any direction. Means this is the type of line here. We can extend from right side also. We can extend from left side also. Means it is not of fixed length. But in case of line segment is of fixed length. Means it have two starting point also and ending point also. Starting point means initial point from which starting, and the ending point means if we have to draw 3 cm of line, then it is not a line, it is type of line segment. Why? Because it starts from 0 and end at 3. So it is the type of line segment. Now ray. A ray has one end point, means it starts from here and end from here. It is the sign of ray. This is the sign of ray. A ray has only one end point. Now, angle. Angle is made up of two line segment. Angle can be made with the help of two line segment. If we have one line segment only, we cannot draw an angle. If we have two line segment, we can draw an angle. Angle are of three types. There are 5 types of angle, but basic types of three types. So, how many angles here? Acute angle, right angle and obtuse angle. Three types of angle. You know all about the degree measurement, like 50 degree, 60 degree, 100 degree, 200 degree, 180 degree, 30 degree. These all are about the types of angle. So, first type of angle is acute angle. An angle whose measure is in between 0 degree and 90 degree. Means it cannot be greater than 90 degree and it cannot be smaller than 0 degree. So, in between 0 degree and 90 degree, it is an acute angle. Now, second one is right angle. Right angle is of exact measurement. Exact measurement means it is of 90 degree only. If we have 91 degree, it is not right angle. If we have 89 degree, it is also not a right angle. Right angle is of exact measurement, means it is of only 90 degree. Next, third one is obtuse angle. Obtuse angle whose measurement is in between 90 degree and 180 degree, means it cannot be greater than 180, it cannot be smaller than 90. Now, 60 degree angle, it is the in between 0 and 90. So, it is acute angle. 30 degree, it is also in between 0 and 90. Therefore, it is also acute angle. 90 degree, it is right angle. If we have 120 degree, it is in between 90 degree and 180 degree. So, it is obtuse angle. Start our next types of angle. There are two more angle here, complement angle and supplement angle. In complement angle and supplement angle, we need two angles. Means, if we add two angles together, then it forms either complement angle or supplement angle. Means, the two angle whose sum is of 90 degree. The two angle whose sum is of 90 degree is known as complement angle. Means, we have two angle. One is of 50 degree, another is 40 degree. If we add this both angles 50 degree and 40 degree together, then it is of 90 degree. 50 plus 40, 90 degree. Then any two angle whose sum is of 90 degree, it is known as complement angle. Like 20 and 70, 20 degree plus 70 degree, it is also of 90 degree. The two angle whose sum is of 90 degree, then this angle is known as complement angle. Now, supplement angle, the two angle whose sum is of 180 degree, means any two angle like 100 degree and 80 degree. If we add this two angle 100 plus 80, then it forms 180 degree. Then any two angle whose sum is of 180 degree, it is known as supplement angle. like 110 plus 70 degree. 110 plus 70 means it is 180 degree. So the complement angle is of 90 degree, supplement angle is of 180 degree. Okay students, now in this chapter there are main four basic concepts here: linear pair, alternate angle, vertically opposite angle and corresponding angle. These all four figures are very helpful to understand lines and angles. So first we will discuss about the linear pair. In linear pair we need two line segment, this and this. One line segment we draw of any centimeter and one line segment is of perpendicular to the next line segment. Perpendicular means it forms the linear pair, means one angle is here and one angle is here. One angle we take any measurement, second angle is of also any measurement, but if we add this two angle then the sum is of 180 degree always. The measurement of linear pair is 180 degree. So look at this figure here. This angle is of 70 degree, this angle is of 110 degree. It is of angle 1 and it is angle 2. 70 plus 180, it forms linear pair. Linear pair also known as semicircle. Semicircle means it is linear pair and it is of 180 degree. So linear pair means the two angle whose sum is of 180 degree, and to form linear pair we need two line segment. One is of any centimeter and one is the perpendicular to it. Next, alternate angle. In alternate angle we need three line segment. These two line segments are parallel to each other. Parallel means it cannot intersect each other at any point. Means if we extend from there and if we extend from here also, but they cannot meet each other, means they cannot intersect. And this line segment, this is also type of line segment, but in case of this, when one line segment cut the parallel line, this line segment is known as transversal. The line segment which cut the two parallel lines, this line segment is known as transversal. So in transversal the two angles are made, one angle is of in this direction, one angle in this direction. Means both the angles direction is opposite to each other. So to form alternate angle we have two parallel line and one transversal. Transversal always cut two parallel lines, and transversal means one angle is opposite direction and one angle is also in opposite direction. This one and two are alternate angle. Next, third, vertically opposite angle. In vertically opposite angle we need two line segment, this line segment and this line segment. So one line segment cut another line segment, then in vertically opposite angle we have two line segment, both cut each other. This line segment cut this line segment and this also cut at this line segment, and this type of angle is known as vertically opposite angle. Angle 1 is here and angle 1 is here, means one angle upward and one angle downward, and this type of angle is known as vertically opposite angle. Next, four type of angle, corresponding angle. In corresponding angle we have this same two parallel line and one transversal. Two parallel line never intersect each other, and transversal means the line segment which cut both the parallel line. But in this case alternate angle we discuss about the two angle which is in opposite direction, but in case of corresponding angle the two angle in same direction, means angle 1 and angle 2, this two angle have same direction, this two angle is known as corresponding angle. So student, in this chapter we have discussed about the so many types of lines and angles. I hope all you have understand it. Thank you and have a nice day.